This is Big Country Mudcat coming back at y'all with another video. But before we get started, I'm going to be dipping on some of that grizzly dark wintergreen. Alright? You know what gets me is this whole race shit. That's what gets to me. The whole racial issue that we seem to have. But you take black folks. You know, most of them are in the game. They don't want to work and bust their ass to make a good, honest living. Instead, they're selling drugs, rapping. And all they ever talk about in this rap music is killing this, fucking this, selling drugs. Then on top of that, you want to be anti-American. This is Big Country Mudcat coming back at y'all with another video. But before we get started, I'm going to be dipping on some of that grizzly dark wintergreen. Alright. You know what gets me is this whole race shit. That's what gets to me. The whole racial issue that we seem to have. But you take black folks. You know, most of them are in the game. They don't want to work and bust their ass to make a good, honest living. Instead, they're selling drugs, rapping. And all they ever talk about in this rap music is killing this, fucking this, selling drugs. Then on top of that, you want to be anti-American.
All right, well, second edition of the 2018 College Football Playoff Poll comes out this Tuesday, but per usual, you don't have to wait till tomorrow to see what that's going to look like. Uncle Lou's going to go ahead and give you a preview of tomorrow's College Football Playoff Poll, and we're going to do that. Subscribe to the Uncle Lou channel if you're not already. I post college football videos almost every single day of the year, and a lot of times they're even watchable and understandable. Whether this one fits into that category or not is up to you. You can decide that after you watch. Give this video a thumbs up. It really helps me out, and I would appreciate it. And let's get right into today's top 10. All right, going to do this the same way we always do it. I'll put last week's poll up on the screen now so you can see what it looked like. Now, this is my poll that I did last Monday, not the official College Football Playoff poll, although they were pretty close. So this is my poll from last week. I'm gonna leave it up. That way you can see what changes, if any, occurred in my poll from last week to this week, and then you guys can compare that to the official College Football Playoff poll if you want to. Any teams lose in the top 10 last week? Yeah, depending on which poll you looked at last week. Of course, you had LSU in the top 10. Some polls had Kentucky in the top 10. Texas, I don't think, was in the top 10 of any polls. Of course, they lost too. So there's going to be some shakeups in this poll, some moving up, some moving down, per usual. We're going to start with number 10 and work our way down like we always do. So here we go. All right, just like every single week this season, UCF starts out number 10 in my poll. I've been saying all along, I'm putting UCF at 10 until they lose a game. I'm never moving them any higher, but I feel like they've won this many games in a row. They deserve some amount of respect, and to me, the right amount is to put them at 10. Now, they were not in the official college football poll last week. Well, they were. They weren't in the top 10. They were number 12. I have a feeling they may be 10 in this week's actual college football poll, which comes out tomorrow. Several teams ahead of Central Florida lost. Now, Central Florida had a struggle win last week against Temple. Was that a Thursday night game? I think it was. They gave up 500 or 600 yards of offense to Temple. Were behind for portions of that game, but they did come back to win that game 52-40, covering the spread once again. The spread was 10.5 on that game. You can make a lot of money betting Central Florida this year and laying the points. They cover way more than they don't because of the polling. They're trying to prove a point, right? They're not out to just win games. They're looking to impress the playoff committee and the voters. So they covered yet again 52-40 over Temple. They play Navy this week. Navy, one of those tricky kind of option type offenses. We'll see how Central Florida can adjust to stop that after looking absolutely atrocious on defense this past week. I expect Central Florida to win, though. They get Navy at home. They'll probably win. No surprise if you've been watching my poll, Central Florida at number 10. But watch out for tomorrow's poll. I think Central Florida may actually be 10 in the real poll tomorrow. Number 9, I got the Corn Dogs this week. Of course, they dropped after losing to Alabama at home 29-0. I had them at number, where did I have them? I had them at 4 in my poll last week. You see on the screen. The official playoff poll, of course, had them at number 3. Now, the question, this is going to be one of the biggest questions, I think, of the actual playoff poll tomorrow. How far will LSU fall in the official playoff poll? Of course, they're out of national title or playoff consideration, in my opinion, but there's going to be some people keeping an eye on that. They're definitely going to be the highest ranked two-loss team, right? Will they stay in the top 10? I think they will. If you watch that LSU-Alabama game, I think LSU played good enough defensively to win that game. I mean, you hold Alabama to 29 points, a couple of field goals there. That's really, I think, the best you can hope to do against Alabama's system offense this year. You hold them under 30. Unfortunately, LSU's offense just wasn't able to get anything going all night. Most of you, I'm sure, watched that game. There's no point in rehashing that. I've got them at number 9. I think the playoff committee will leave them in the top 10. They play on the road at Arkansas this week, so good opportunity for a bounce-back game for LSU. Arkansas, one of the worst teams in the Power 5, without question. But I'll keep an eye on this. I guess it's possible they drop them out of the top 10, but I have a feeling I may be right on this one, too, with LSU at number 9. All right, number 8, Washington State. And let me say something real quick right here. I do not think Washington State is a top 10 team. I don't. I'm not a believer in the Pac-12 at all. I've really, since the offseason, have been saying I don't think the Pac-12 is going to have a playoff team this year. Washington was the pick out of the Pac-12 if you were hoping on a playoff team, and they've just stumbled way too many times this year and haven't really looked like the dominant team a lot of people expected them to be. Oregon has a couple of unexplainable losses. Southern Cal is pretty much a 500 team at this point. The Pac-12, just very underwhelming. However, they won again. They're still sitting on just the one loss. I didn't have Washington State ranked at all last week in my initial college football playoff poll, but the actual playoff poll had them at number 8. Now, they barely won this week against a below-average Cal team. They won 19-13. They got to go on the road this week to play Colorado. Colorado started out 5-0 and haven't won a game since. They've lost 4 in a row, so they're 5-4. Washington State should be a big favorite again, even though it's on the road at Colorado. We'll see if they can keep the win streak going. I don't think, listen, I can easily name 10 teams that I think could beat Washington State, but the point is they play in a major conference, a Power 5 conference. They're sitting on one loss. They're probably going to get some respect for that. I view Washington State really very similar to the way I view Central Florida. I just don't think they've really played anybody. Their non-conference schedule was absolutely pitiful, Washington State was. They don't play a single Power 5 team outside of the Pac-12. I just don't think, even if they run the table and win the Pac-12 with a final record of, what would that be, 12-1, I still think they'll be lucky to get higher than sixth or seventh in that final playoff poll. I'm just not a believer in the Cougars, although it is fun to listen to Mike Leach ramble on about Bigfoot and aliens and UFOs and weather manipulation and all that kind of stuff. That is entertaining. But as far as Washington State as a football team, I'm just not really a believer that they're an elite team. However, like I said, one loss, number eight, that's probably where they'll stay this week. All right, now I already know this one's going to be a little controversial here. This one was kind of hard to do for me, but at the number seven spot, I left Oklahoma at seven. Yes, they won last week. Yes, a team ahead of them lost in LSU. However, Oklahoma's defense just continues to struggle pretty much week after week after week. Every once in a while, they're able to put together a pretty good game defensively, but then they go right back to the old Oklahoma that we know and love that can't seem to stop anybody. They beat a terrible, really, Texas Tech team 51-46. I mean, this is a typical Oklahoma game right here. You see this almost every week with Oklahoma. They get the win. They score a ton of points. They give up a bunch of yards and a bunch of points. 51-46 over Texas Tech. Now, this week, of course, is the Bedlam game. They host Oklahoma State. It'll be another one of these type of games. I'm just telling you right now, don't be shocked if the over-under on this game is close to 100 points here. It'll be worth watching for sure. Oklahoma State, a little disappointing this year, but they've got some offensive players over there. Is it Justice Hill? Is that the running back's name? He's really, really good. Anyway, Oklahoma, another track meet coming up this weekend. I couldn't justify moving Oklahoma above the team I have here at number six. And I guess we'll get to that in a second. But Oklahoma, an elite offensive team like they are every single year. I don't think Oklahoma's offense is quite as good as it was last year. Rodney Anderson, of course, hurt, has announced he won't come back. He's going to enter the NFL draft. Trey Sermon playing really, really good, though. Georgia boy out of the state of Georgia. So Oklahoma wins again, still sitting on the one loss. That big game at the end of the year with West Virginia is looming. But right now, I feel it's fair to leave them at number seven. All right, and like I mentioned, a little controversy, but West Virginia number six. I just feel like West Virginia has looked like a better team this year than Oklahoma, in my opinion. Kyler Murray is good. Will Greer is better, in my mind. I like Oklahoma's wide receivers. I think West Virginia's wide receivers are better. Oklahoma's defense, terrible. West Virginia's defense, way better, I think, than a lot of people thought it would be. Now, they played in the track meet game themselves this weekend against Texas, winning 42-41. On what can only be described as one of the most gutsy calls in recent memory in college football. Of course, West Virginia scored to make it a one-point game with 16 seconds to go. They were down by one, 41-40. An extra point would have tied it up and most likely sent the game to overtime with only 16 seconds remaining. They elected to go for two. A very, very ballsy move by Dana Holgerson, West Virginia head coach, and it paid off. They hit the two-point conversion. They beat Texas on the road in Texas, 42-41. Huge win, again, setting up that epic showdown at the end of the year with Oklahoma. Now, West Virginia still has a couple of tough games left. I think they still play, they play TCU this week. So, in any case, though, if you want to say West Virginia should be seven and Oklahoma should be six, it's not like that's totally unreasonable. I would understand that. Again, to me, this is just the eye test. I've just been more impressed with West Virginia this season overall than I have Oklahoma. If you look at the actual playoff poll from last week, West Virginia was not even ranked, which I thought was a huge, huge mistake. That didn't make any sense to me at all. I had West Virginia number nine last week in my poll. Again, a big win over a good Texas team. I'm moving them up to number six, leaving Oklahoma at seven. But again, don't get too upset if you're an Oklahoma fan here. Y'all are going to play. You may play twice in back-to-back weeks, depending on how this Big 12 thing shakes out with the regular season and the Big 12 title game. So Oklahoma will get their chance to play West Virginia. But for this week, I think this is fair. Oklahoma seven, Mountaineers six. All right, here we go with the top five, and the first team on the outside looking in on the college football playoff, the Georgia Bulldogs. Big win on the road this week against Kentucky. Cry if you want that Kentucky was overrated. Believe me, I'm used to this. No matter who Georgia plays, they're going to kill us. I mean, all week, all I hear is how, you know, we're not going to win the game. We can't do this. We can't do that. We got to play at Kentucky. Kentucky's got this. Kentucky got that. And just insert any team for Kentucky, whatever team we're playing. Then Georgia comes out and beats them. And then the next week, it's, well, they were just overrated. They just had a big game. They just did this. They just did that. Big deal, blah, blah, blah. Who have Georgia play? Woo! The whole, I mean, you know the routine by now. But anyway, Georgia goes on the road, gets a dominating win, 34-17 at Kentucky. Got Auburn coming to Athens this week. I don't think the Auburn game is going to be quite as easy of a game as a lot of people seem to think. And, of course, Uncle Lou will be there. Yeah, that's right. I'm going to the Georgia-Auburn game this weekend, taking Lou Jr., my dad, my brother, and my nephew. We'll be up in Athens this weekend for that game. We'll be there all day, probably be up there around 10 or 11 in the morning. The game's at 7 o'clock at night, so I have plenty of time to hang around up there during the day before the game. But I think 5 is fair for Georgia. If you look at the poll from last week, my poll, I had them at 6, so I just moved them up to one spot, which is really just because LSU lost. And you look at the real playoff poll, they had Georgia at 6 as well. So hard to argue this one. Georgia, I think, will definitely be ranked 5th when the official playoff poll comes out tomorrow. Most of the arguments in this poll, I think, are going to take place between the 6 and 10 spots. Very little to argue about in 1 through 5, in my opinion. But this week, I've got Georgia at number 5. All right, number 4 is Michigan, and I'm telling you something right now. Michigan is an extremely dangerous team right now. They have got an absolute elite defense. In my opinion, Michigan is the best defense I've seen this year. I think Clemson is probably the most talented defense, and over the last couple of weeks, they have looked really, really good. Not so much in the beginning of the year, but Clemson's defense does look really good now. But for my money this year, what I've seen from week one till now, Michigan's defense is absolutely lights out. Their offense is starting to come around. An absolute beatdown on Penn State at home, 42-7. Say what you want about Penn State already having 2 losses, this now being their 3rd. Penn State is a good team. Are they great? Are they elite? No, but they're a good team. Prior to this game, Penn State's 2 losses were by a combined 5 points. They had a 1-point loss and a 4-point loss before this 35-point drubbing at the hands of the Wolverines. Jim Harbaugh's got the offense clicking. That's been the missing ingredient for Michigan for a couple of years now. That's no secret. I'm not telling you anything you don't know. Their defense has been unbelievable, really, for the last 3 seasons. And this may be the best defense they've had yet. It's definitely the best offense Harbaugh has had in Michigan. And they are a very, very dangerous team. And if you're paying attention to this poll and you're noticing a team that's not in it, Ohio State, a miracle win against a 2-win Nebraska team, a pitiful and pathetic performance by Ohio State this past weekend. And there was no excuse for it. Ohio State was coming off of a bye week. The week before that bye week, they got blown out by Purdue. Good teams do lose sometimes, Ohio State. So, yeah, I gave you a hard time about losing to Purdue, but good teams do catch an L on occasion, get caught sleeping or whatever, but they usually bounce back with their best performance of the year. See Georgia, LSU, and then Georgia, Florida as Exhibit A. You came out and absolutely stunk it up against a terrible Nebraska team, and to make matters worse, you're staring down the barrel of a matchup with Michigan coming up in about 3 or 4 weeks, and right now it looks like Michigan is going to absolutely destroy Ohio State. Michigan is playing at a very, very high level right now. I've got them at 4. I think they'll be at 4 in the real playoff poll that comes out tomorrow. Well, where was Michigan last week? Last week, Michigan was 5th, so again, they move up one spot with the LSU loss. I also had them 5th last week. I'm no Harbaugh fan. I've made more than my fair share of videos giving Harbaugh a hard time when he obviously deserved it. But if you're hating on Michigan at this point in the season, then you're just hating on Michigan. If you try to sit here and tell me Michigan's not a good elite team with a chance to win it all this year, you're out of your mind and you haven't watched Michigan play. They are the real deal. They go on the road this week to play Rutgers. This will be another 40-something to 10 type of game. Rutgers is terrible. It may even be worse than that, so they're not losing this week. But anyway, the Wolverines 4 this week in the Uncle Lou playoff poll. All right, Notre Dame. I've been higher on Notre Dame than a lot of people have for the majority of the season. I still give Notre Dame a lot of credit for that win over Michigan. Michigan looks like a better team today than Notre Dame does. However, I just couldn't justify putting Michigan ahead of a team that they lost to. Notre Dame's still undefeated. They win 31-21 this past weekend against Northwestern. Not a dominating performance by any stretch of the imagination, but a 10-point win on the road against a Northwestern team that has looked a lot better over the last couple of weeks than they did in the beginning of the season. Northwestern's quarterback finally starting to play like the quarterback we saw last year. Notre Dame goes on the road, gets a big win, stays undefeated. And the thing about Notre Dame is they can win the rest of their games by 1 point. They're still getting into playoffs if they go 12-0, no matter how much you hate them. And I don't like them either. This week they play Florida State, which is probably the most disappointing team in America. I don't see any way Notre Dame loses this game. It's in South Bend. Florida State would have to play by far its best game of the season, and Notre Dame would have to shoot itself in the foot multiple times for this game to even be close, in my opinion. So it looks like they're going to be sitting at, 9-0, 10-0, whatever that makes them. They'll be undefeated again, in my opinion. That week one game, man, a close game at Notre Dame. Michigan lost by one score. Both these teams, to me, look better than they did week one. Notre Dame made a quarterback change. Michigan had brought in a new quarterback. That was his first start. It took Michigan a few weeks to get that offense up and running. If these two teams played again, wouldn't surprise me to see Michigan win, especially on a neutral field, considering how close that game was week one. But anyway, we may see a rematch of these two teams in the playoffs if things continue on the same path they're on now. But I've got Notre Dame sitting at number three. All right, number two, I had Clemson. Now, for the last couple of weeks, I've had Notre Dame ahead of Clemson, mainly because of some wins that Notre Dame had versus Clemson not really having any good wins. But Clemson over the last couple of weeks had beat an undefeated NC State team. And besides that, they're just absolutely dominating teams at this point in the season. They win this week 77-6. I mentioned NC State, they beat 42-7. Before that, I believe it was Wake Forest. They beat 63-3. Clemson's offense looks unstoppable at this point. If there's any offense right now that looks better than Bama's, it's Clemson's. And that may make the Bama fans mad. I don't know. But what Clemson is doing on offense right now is unreal. Of course, freshman quarterback Trevor Lawrence putting up 300 yards and three or four touchdowns in every single game the last few games here. They look unstoppable on offense. Clemson's front seven is loaded with NFL talent. I question or have some questions about their secondary and their ability to defend the pass, but really you're nitpicking if you try to find a weakness on Clemson's team at all right now. They look absolutely unstoppable. They go on the road this week to play number 17, Boston College. Boston College, a pretty good team with a really good running back in A.J. Dillon. Boston College really offensively reminds me sort of Kentucky. They have one good player, a running back. You run him into the ground the first 2 months of the season. Now you look at A.J. Dillon, he's hobbling around. Similar situation to Benny Snell at Kentucky. I expect Clemson to dominate Boston College, honestly. I do not think that'll be a close game. I know Boston College is 17. I don't expect that to be a close game. Of course, I'll talk a lot more about that game on Wednesday when I do the top 25 preview, but Clemson looks really, really good right now, and I have them at number two. All right, and of course, that leaves Bama at number one, dominating win over LSU on the road in Baton Rouge, 29-0. They play at home this week against number 18, Mississippi State, another game that I don't expect to be close, honestly. I do think Mississippi State's got a pretty good defense, particularly the front four and front seven. However, offensively, they don't have anywhere near enough to be able to compete with an Alabama team. Nick Fitzgerald can't complete a pass. He likes to run around, but Alabama's got plenty of speed on defense. I don't think Nick Fitzgerald will go nuts running the ball on Alabama's defense. I expect the Mississippi State game, honestly, to be very similar to what we saw in the LSU game, with Bama probably scoring one or two touchdowns more. I could see Bama getting into the low 40s in this game and Mississippi State struggling, honestly, to get to 10 or 14 points. I think it'll be that lopsided at home here. For Alabama, I have them at number one. So does every other poll you look at, whether it's the playoff poll, AP, coaches, whatever. They've been number one all season long. No reason they won't be, at least not until December 1st. Yeah. But don't worry, we got 30 days to remind the Gumps that their season ends on the first Saturday in December. Don't have to worry about that. And no, two SEC teams are not making the playoffs this year. If you don't understand why that is, and you just don't, then you just don't understand football. But a one-loss team that doesn't win their division or their conference is not jumping a one-loss Michigan, an undefeated Notre Dame, a Clemson, a one-loss Big 12 champion. I mean, none of that is happening. So, Alabama fans and everybody else who thinks that the committee just loves Alabama for no reason and Alabama could lose to Georgia and Atlanta and still get into the playoffs, you couldn't be more wrong. And if you don't believe me, just wait and find out, because Georgia indeed will beat Alabama, and Alabama will be playing probably Central Florida in a New Year's Six Bowl, and Central Florida will get their wish with the whole We Want Bama thing. Anyway, type on that and have a good morning.